There's always something coming and going on Netflix with every new month, but May just might be one of the best months yet. From a whole bunch of new releases to the return of fan favorites, here's everything good coming to Netflix in May 2019. The dark comedy Dead to Me stars Christina Applegate as a grieving widow named Jen who attends a support group and meets a woman named Lucy, played by Bloodline's Linda Cardellini. The two bond over their shared grief, become friends, move in together, and everything goes completely off the rails. It turns out Lucy is kind of, maybe totally crazy, and now she's living in the same house as Jen and her kids. The trailer for Dead to Me teases a heartfelt drama infused with the kind of humor that could only come from having Will Ferrell and Adam McKay as executive producers. Tune in when the series arrives on May 3rd. The title of this one says it all. Extremely Wicked, Shockingly Evil and Vile is about the trial and imprisonment of notorious serial killer Ted Bundy, told through the perspective of a single mother who dated Bundy before his crimes came to light.
I'm disguised as an attorney today.
Zac Efron stars as Bundy, with Lily Collins in the role of Elizabeth. Extremely Wicked, Shockingly Evil and Vile has all the makings of a dark, twisted descent into the mind of a killer. Take a look when it lands on May 3rd. Flinch is an upcoming reality show that works in the same vein as Fear Factor. Contestants are put into gut-wrenching situations and tasked with not flinching. Whoever flinches the least wins. What kind of stuff are they doing? In the trailer, we see challenges as simple as having a firecracker pop next to you or a guy smashing cymbals right behind your head, all the way up to seriously flinch-worthy situations like being strapped to a chair while a cement block on a rope swings inches past your nose. You can squeal in terror when the first season swings in on May 3rd. For its first three seasons, Lucifer was the property of Fox, and Netflix added seasons after they aired. But now that Fox has dumped the series, Netflix swooped in to grab the rights, and they produced the upcoming fourth season. Other than that, nothing much is going to change. It's still the story of Lucifer after he gets bored with hell and moves to LA. Hell 2.0, if you will.
Oh, it's times like this I wish I was still in hell.
The fourth season of Lucifer arrives on May 8th, so keep your eyes peeled for that. The Society centers on an affluent town in which everybody except the teenagers mysteriously vanishes. It isn't long before they develop their own rules for survival. If you aren't with the cool crowd, you might just end up 6 feet under. It looks like a cross between Mean Girls and The Purge, which is the kind of premise you never thought you'd look forward to. But now that it's here, well, we're pretty pumped. Tune in for season one of The Society when it drops on May 10th. Wine Country follows a group of friends as they head into the Napa Valley for a carefully planned weekend of boozing to celebrate the 50th birthday of Abby, played by Amy Poehler. But once all that wine starts stirring around regrets and repressed emotions, the itinerary goes out the window, and this group of friends takes a nosedive into a long, hard look at their lives. Fun! Maya Rudolph, Jason Schwartzman, and Tina Fey co-star, and Amy Poehler is directing. Pour a glass and settle in when Wine Country premieres on May 10th. Even though it's ramping into its second season, a lot of Netflix viewers have probably never heard of White Gold. The show centers on a team of salesmen in a showroom in the 80s who think business ethics is just a fancy phrase for making as much money as possible, no matter what it takes. If you're looking for a new comedy series to binge, be sure to check out White Gold when the second season lands on May 17th. The first season of the Danish thriller series The Rain was praised by critics for its writing and characters. It's about a group of people banding together to survive after a rain-borne plague wipes out most of humanity. The series centers on two siblings who leave their bunker to find other survivors. If you missed the first season of The Rain, queue it up and get ready for the second season to fall on May 17th. Spike Lee is producing this time travel joint, which sees two high school kids on the cusp of finishing a pair of time-warping backpacks when one of their brothers is shot by police. They decide to use the backpacks to go back in time and stop the incident from taking place. Of course, things go wrong pretty quickly, and they find themselves in a loop of mistakes that they desperately try to unravel. Apparently, time travel isn't as easy as it looks. Jump in for the ride when See You Yesterday shows up on May 17th. Netflix's horror series Slasher brought in solid reviews on its first outing, thanks mostly to its dedication to the genre. Structured on the slasher movies of the 80s and 90s, it manages to pay tribute to those films while still bringing plenty of new stuff to the table. The newest installment, Solstice, isn't coming with a lot of pre-release details. All we know is that if it's anything like the first two installments, we're 100% in. Take a look on May 23rd. Netflix has been adding some pretty twisted high-concept horror lately with releases like Velvet Buzzsaw and Await Further Instructions. And continuing that trend in May is The Perfection. Allison Williams of Get Out stars as a musical prodigy who returns to her roots at her former school, only to get an unexpected surprise in the form of a younger student who appears to be deeply disturbed. There aren't many details available for the rest of the plot, and most reviewers have stressed how important it is to go into The Perfection completely blind. We're looking forward to doing just that when The Perfection drops on May 24th. How to Sell Drugs Online Fast is based on a ridiculous true story about a teenager in Germany who was trying to show his girlfriend how cool he was. So, he made a little business selling drugs over the internet. Before long, he was one of the top drug dealers on the continent. As the title suggests, How to Sell Drugs Online Fast plays as a sort of dramatic guide to everything this kid did. You can find it on Netflix on May 31st. Heart-wrenching and dramatic, When They See Us is a limited series focused on the Central Park Five, five teens who were falsely convicted of assaulting a woman in New York's Central Park in 1989. After spending years in prison, their convictions were overturned in 2002 in light of new evidence confirming their innocence. When They See Us will paint a dramatic portrait of the young men's lives before and after the crime, and the discrimination they faced during the trial. Look for it on May 31st. Those are all the best Netflix originals coming in May. Now let's look at everything else. Explosions, kung fu, and space dinosaurs fill out the docket for May's action editions. On May 1st, all three of the Matrix films plug into the streaming service. In the mood for a more thoughtful fare? Check out Snowpiercer, a 2013 post-apocalyptic film starring Chris Evans as a lowly citizen on board a train carrying the last remnants of humanity. There's also going to be a wide range of thriller and horror films landing on Netflix next month, from movies like The Final Destination and Scream to more low-key adventure thrillers like The Da Vinci Code and its sequel Angels and Demons. All of those selections arrive on the first of the month. Also on the 1st, look for dramas like Hoosiers, Scarface, and Revolutionary Road, not to mention the mind-bending cult classic Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Then, on the 4th, don't miss War Horse, Steven Spielberg's 2011 World War I drama that will turn you into a horse lover whether you want to be one or not. If you find yourself on the credits end of Revolutionary Road come May 1st and desperately need a pick-me-up, you'll have plenty of options. Netflix is doubling down on comedies next month, bringing back raunchy genre favorites like the first two Austin Powers films, Dumb and Dumber, Harold and Kumar Escape from Guantanamo Bay, and Wedding Crashers. Look for those on the 1st. Fans of CW superheroes rejoice. Netflix is adding new seasons of the hottest superhero shows throughout the month, promising all the spandex and CGI you could ever want. Arrow shows up on the 21st, The Flash on the 22nd, and season 4 of both Supergirl and Legends of Tomorrow on the 31st. And if you've spent the last decade and a half following the adventures of Sam and Dean Winchester, you'll also be able to catch up on season 14 of Supernatural on the 3rd. It's a little bittersweet since fans know the long-running show will finally be entering the afterlife after its 15th season. Other shows to look for include Colony season 3 on the 2nd, Pose season 1 on the 10th, Riverdale season 3 on the 23rd, and the first two seasons of Outlander on the 27th. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite Netflix stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.